beautiful this morning.
Good morning, sunshine. It's time to draw the drapes. The blinds are coming up. Your blue cup. Uh-oh. Good morning, babe.
Good morning.
You want breakfast?
Yeah.
What would you like for breakfast?
Sleep.
No sleep allowed. Time to go. The dawn is breaking. The dawn has broken.
Lord.
Look at this beautiful day. I just want you to see the beautiful day we have outside. What is happening in America? Look at this day, babe. Look at this. Look at Century City just waiting for you to go tackle it.
Mm-hmm. It's tackled.
I'm sorry, you don't tackle. You're a running back.
I'll tackle now.
You tackle now. All right. Egg whites?
Mm-hmm.
Breakfast of champions?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, wake up.
Good morning, babe.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Wait, let's try again.
Hey, you gotta cut it.
Okay. How are we now?
Hey, what's going on?
Morning.
What's going on?
What's going on?
Nothing. Oh, we have a video shoot here today.
Oh, that's something.
Sorry, forgot to tell you. We got our house back. Wait, good morning. There's going to be a video shoot here today. Naked girls, rappers, the whole nine yards.
Booty cheeks everywhere.
Sign me up. What do I audition?
Stevin, don't lie. You like big butt. Look at your big butt. Doesn't have a cash out card. Mm-hmm. He says he has a cash out the whole time. We, for two reasons, asked him to drive for the Veracruz Classic. The Sprinter's already in San Diego, so we're like, hey, can you pick up the Sprinter in San Diego, bring it back? Oh my God, finally I get a job. Like, you guys never call me anymore. Ever since he geeked over a celebrity, and we were like, no, we can't ask for certain things, right?
Geeked over a celebrity?
Yeah. Not even a celebrity. Who was the guy?
JB Smoove, a D-list.
No, you haven't heard of that.
He's a D-list comedian. I'm more famous than him.
I've never even heard of that person.
The mayor of San Diego is more famous than JB Smoove. The guy ends up, he takes the job. The night before, he picks up the Sprinter. There's no gas in it. Which is number one. You know how Derrell is.
Yeah.
Like, the day we have a job, Daryl's up at 5:30 in the morning. He's cleaning the Sprinter. He's getting dressed up.
Hey, before you keep going, look how beautiful my breakfast came out. Amazing, ain't it?
I thought he was going to say, look how beautiful my wife is in the morning.
They already know that. Anyway, keep going.
Okay, so he gets here to do the job. I've been asking him for like 3 days before that, like, do you have a cash app? Yes. Do you have cash app? Yes. So that morning, I'm like, dude, you need to be able to handle expenses, you know, while you're out. What's your cash app? So he sends me some random girl's name of a cash app, and I was like, okay, that's not your cash app, but do you have, not my business, right? Mm-hmm. Do you have a card that's attached to that so you can access it? He's like, no. What? I'm like, dude, I told you months ago that you need to get a cash app card, but fine, you don't have one. Do you have one that's attached to this card? No. Okay, well then, let me just put it in your bank. I don't have a bank account anymore.
Okay. I don't have a bank account anymore.
Anyway, the guy doesn't have a bank account, doesn't have a cash app, because I think he burned his cash app out. And,
he wants us to send the money he made to Shaquita.
So we send the money to this other cash app that he can't access.
Can't
so now he has no money. He's in LA.
Mm-hmm.
He somehow, thank God, on fumes got the client back. Thank you, Lord. Forgive. He got the client back. Drops off the client. We get a call Saturday night.
Yes.
Jonathan is stuck in LA. You ready? He's sitting at a gas station asking people.
Bruh.
Swear to God.
Bruh.
I wish it was a lie.
No.
He asked people for money like he homeless. We homeless, but we can't even get the money for gas. We in San Diego, he in LA, he had no cash up or no cash. How will we get him the money in LA? He asked for people with a big old Sprinter limo with our name on it.
No.
With a shirt that says Elite Lux.
No.
You have any gas money?
Yeah. I promise you, what was my word of the day? Mortified. I called Brian at first, didn't even think of that yet. He's like, man, can you believe this? And he was kind of laughing about it. And I'm like, dude, it's not funny. Like, he's out there with my name. He's got a big, giant E.
This Bruh.
Is outside. Oops.
So every morning we have the same routine. We kind of get up, eat breakfast, and kind of go through our inquiries that we get on our website every morning. It consists of things from our homes to private jets to cars to chauffeurs to chefs. We offer a wide variety of things. And this is kind of how mornings start every day for us. So it's typically slow for the first 2 hours, and then it's all gas after that. So you'll see.
Sensitivity. It's about passion. It's about unconditional giving of self to another person. And
it's about
this love of humanity.
Unconditional that's giving of oneself right to another person.
Love of humanity. But in everything in
love of
that
money,
love, there is a soul. It's like when you take some eggs and break them.
They want to see. We the ones.
No, we're not. Everybody, this is the thing about
they looking for Kim and Kanye, but they fail to realize they live in Calabasas. They don't live in LA.
The thing is, everybody comes here and they think they want to see somebody, so they want you to be somebody so bad. Shit, that little girl from
I'm Martin Luther King, little brother. welcome to LA.
That little girl in the jacuzzi at the hotel, like, it's Kim and Kanye. I look more as much like him as he
looked
like Kanye.
Well, I gotta be Kanye though.
What?
What?
You know what? It's the black, and is she white or is she something else?
Thanks. I'll send you over the agreement on probably about, or Derrell can get it too. Maybe in like 10 minutes. I'm about to leave. Yeah. Look for a DocuSign. Could go to your clutter or whatever. You know what that is. Okay. 2250. It's a 7 day for this house. We'll go lower because it's a 7 day. 2250, 5,000 security deposit, 500 cleaning. Today by noon. What time is it, babe?
10:45.
Yeah. Say today by 5 p.m. Close of business is fine. All right. Thanks.
What's this for?
This house, 9th through the 15th.
Right.
Or sorry, 9th through the 16th, so they're gonna get the date, like, go an extra day and we'll give them with you, right?
Okay.
There's a cruise we could go on. 9th through the 15th. If you can look for a jet to Miami today, we have, I don't know, I'll call Chantel, see if she can book it. So I'm a little nervous. I'm in the back of an Uber right now, on my way home, and I rented out our last car, meaning I rented out
my personal car without asking Derrell if he was okay with it, because I knew he'd say no. It's a super busy weekend. We rented out all the houses, including our own, and we rented out all the cars, and we were down to my personal car, which is now gone. So let's see how he reacts when I pull up. I called Stephen and asked him to film it for us so we can get an honest reaction from Derrell. All right.
All right. Thank you. It was so nice talking to you. You're going to have a great weekend, I'm sure. Hey, babe.
Oh, wow. You got a lot done here. What time are they checking in?
Suspects. What'd you do?
Babe.
What?
I rented it.
Ever since when?
Today.
So now we got no cars. So it means we got to drive. What I'm washing around? I don't like driving.
No, that's going out tomorrow morning.
Jesus. So what are we going to do?
Babe, it's triple surge pricing. We're like Uber.
Look.
Triple surge.
Get
it. Okay,
$1,500
a day.
I love making money, but having no car sucks. That's like All-Star Weekend. Over again.
We love how we live. We love where we live. The trade-off is that we gotta pack it up.
Jesus.
And Uber's really busy this weekend, too. The Uber driver just told me that, like, they're doing major surge pricing all weekend. So we may have to take the bus if we can't catch an Uber.
Yeah, get on the bus and tell the people, hey, this is fun, huh?
Choo-choo.
I did the MTS system all my childhood life. I'm not getting back on the bus.
Well, for me, it's fun because I have it. Actually, I took the 26th in San Jose all the way to the roller rink every weekend. Look at this.
Hey, wait up. We do got another car.
What?
Take this one. Hey, right,
you got all the classes?
Hey, we can take Booger car. I'll take this one. Take that one.
All right, I got dibs on the unicorn, though.
Oh, the unicorn. Right. Babe, you packed up my closet, too?
Yeah.
I love you.
I got all my clothes. That's some of our clothes. I still got to put more in now.
Okay, where are the clothes that we're going to wear for the next week and a half?
I don't know.
Steven, did you pack all your stuff?
Mm-hmm. I don't unpack.
All right. Well, I think it would be fun to take a train trip, actually. Let me call it Amtrak. Train. I'm not saying the bus, okay? I'm joking about the bus. You're gonna throw that dirty rag at me. Please don't do that. Babe, I was so nervous about how you were gonna react. I was so nervous. $1,500 a day.
Look, I love making money, but I don't love being carless. I'm sorry. But it's your car, so what can I say?
Babe.
Sorry, I'm gonna catch a Greyhound somewhere.
On the Hudson River line.
Graham, shoot.
We're good.
K9 or something.